No, I'm telling you, Johnny and Tisha just broke up. It just came across my mind to watch again. My mom needs to talk to me, gotta go. Mom, Cece and Tisha were dishing.
Dishing, Mom? You should thank Hedy Lamarr for all that gossip.
Who's Hedy Lamarr?
She invented all that cell phone, Bluetooth, and spread spectrum technology. She was named the most beautiful girl in the world in the 1930s.
Wait, you're telling me a woman from the 1930s invented all this stuff? And she was the most beautiful woman in the world. Did they even let women be inventors back then?
Hedy Lamarr's story is one of beauty, science, and compromise during World War II. Hedy was born and grew up in Vienna, Austria. Her father was in her box, leaving out all the engineering marvels around him, giving Hedy a new love of science. Hedy also loved acting and followed that dream all the way to Berlin, where she started the controversial opening ecstasy, which Hitler banned for Hedy's Jewish heritage. Friedrich Mandel, a rich German arms dealer, fell in love with Hedy's beauty. They were married in 1933. Hedy soon learned that she was merely a trophy wife. All anyone ever saw was her face. Never mind, she listened in on Friedrich's meetings, looking for escape from the prison. Simple story circle her escape, and eventually she made her way to the United States as MGM's newest Hollywood star.
The U.S. took so long to enter the war. Now Germany is bombing London, and their U-boats are killing refugee children. I have no way of knowing if my family is safe. We may not keep kosher, but I was born Jewish. This madman has to be stopped. Him and his armies and his U-boats and his torpedoes. The U.S. has a lot of heart, but their torpedoes fail 60% of the time. German boats are returning to port stuck full of undetonated torpedoes, and that's when the torpedoes don't detonate early or miss entirely. I've heard that some U.S. captains won't even arm the torpedoes in the tubes because they're afraid of blowing up their own ship. I've got to do something, but I'm just an actress. Still, I know a lot about German hardware. They're having problems with their communication systems for their torpedoes. They're trying to use radio communication, but that's easy to jam by throwing out noise on the same frequency. As each frequency is jammed, they go up into higher and higher frequencies. It's impractical, and the U.S. knows it, which is why they're trying to fire and forget or fly by wire, which is one of the reasons they miss. But if I can solve the jamming problem, this is going to work! I don't understand. The Inventors Council gave my project the highest endorsement. They know it works. And we even gave the Navy the patent. Instead of using the jam-proof spread spectrum technology, they rattle off nonsense about it being too big, even though it can fit inside a pocket watch. If that's too big, then they should work with us to implement the technology in a smaller size, not reject it out of hand. I offered to go to work with the National Inventors Council. I'm offering them my help, my mind, and my willingness to do anything to see this madman stopped, yet they reject it all. They told me to take my pretty face and go sell war bonds. I shouldn't be surprised. This isn't the first time the government has rejected a woman's mind because her face is pretty. What about that great medical scientist, Rosalind Sussman-Yalo? She has a doctor in front of her name. Only 3% of women in California, Hawaii, and Montana have postgraduate education, and those are the best states in the nation. Dr. Yalo tried to work for the VA, but the government thinks if she's good-looking, what is she doing in medicine? And if she's not good-looking, who wants her? Dr. Yalo got turned down for a job in a lab the other day because she was too pretty and would be a distracting influence. Now here I am, the most beautiful woman in the world, trying to help the government in the field of science. And to make it worse, I want to help the Navy. The Navy only lets women assist as nurses. Maybe they're right. Maybe that's all I am, just window dressing for the war. What do they tell me? If I want to contribute, I have to do what all the other actresses are doing. I have to sell war bonds and kiss soldiers. It's valuable work. Sure, we have to pay for the torpedoes somehow, even if they can't hit their targets. I just can't help but wish that... No, they've been more than clear that all of my time working on inventions is a waste. I need to focus on helping those men who can actually make a difference in this war. The conflict of World War II is not going away anytime soon, and if they won't accept my efforts as an inventor, then I will compromise and help in any way I can. Even as window dressing. Window dressing. At least I'm pretty window dressing. US government was throwing millions of dollars into torpedo research and development, but they never would have accepted women like Hetty as a source of scientific discovery. Women were asked to help the war effort, but they were valued for their willingness to do repetitive, tedious work. They entered the workforce as riveters, munitions manufacturers, and number crunchers. They were asked to do math, but they were not welcomed as idea formers, decision makers. Hetty was not that kind of a woman, but she was willing to do what it took to see Germany defeated. Hetty went off to work at the Hollywood canteen. One of the prizes for soldiers headed out to war was a kiss by Hetty Lamarr. During a break from the canteen, she took the war bond front by storm and sold $25 million worth of war bonds, or $343 million today. Within a decade, the Navy was using her patents and her idea in their Navy ships. It was invaluable during the Cold War, and it was the basis of sonobuoys, hydrophones, and a plethora of military communications. When they finally declassified her patent, the civilian population started to benefit with cell phones, balloon truth devices, fax machines, and Wi-Fi. So where was Hetty Lamarr during this time of technological triumph? Hetty's decision to compromise her role as an inventor in World War II impacted the rest of her life. She never went back to a role as an inventor. She never received compensation for her inventing genius. Instead, she put the whole of herself into her acting career. The US Navy and society had taught this brilliant woman that her only worth lay in the fleeting bloom of youthful beauty. When Hetty no longer felt she was the most beautiful woman in the world, she became a recluse. One of the most brilliant minds in the world wasted away in seclusion for almost 60 years. This brilliant woman, whose name should be known amongst the names of Guglielmo Marconi, Samuel Morse, and Alexandra Graham Bell, was forgotten. Instead, not a day goes by without you using her technology, and yet hardly anyone even knows her name. Those who do know her as the most beautiful woman in the world, they know for her acting career, not her inventing genius. Hetty's potential was never fully unlocked. Hetty was more than window dressing. She was a genius inventor whose inventions died with her. What's cute about little Cutie? It's beauty, not brains. Keep young and beautiful. It's your duty to be